Just to let you know, I have been farming the lives. Look at this. I have 54 lives. Like, not too long ago, I had, like, what? Maybe even single-digit amount of lives? Look what I do. I got one cherry. Now that's two. Three. Four. Just get the same cherry until you got it five times. The star will appear. You will grab that. You will not fuck this up, because if you do, you'll lose out on time. You will not mess that up. And then, from the midpoint of... Yeah, Ariel way. Still spelled wrong. You will be killing as many enemies as you can. Rinse and repeat. Now I have 9 more lives than I had just before. Rinse and repeat. Now that's how you get as many lives as you want in Hunter's Revenge 2 Recharged. That's got to be the best way I can think of. Now let's get back on track here. What were we doing? Oh yeah, we were going into... World 11! Man, this is a huge game. And I'm on, like, what? Part 36 of it? So, Dark Mountain Path. Which I now have 11 hearts because I found, like, 4 in the Spring of Life. But apparently the Mountain Castle, now the Master Prison, has been nerfed. Apparently that's going to be a contender for the hardest level in the hack now. So I'm not home free. So even with 11 hearts, it's still going to be a nightmarish gauntlet of hell. Well, if I would fall in a hole, I would still die instantly. Not like that's ever going to change. No matter how many hearts you have, it's instant death if you fall in a hole. It's just that having 11... It's gonna make things a lot easier. But I wonder what that's gonna mean for the difficulty. I wonder what that's gonna look like from now on. Well, granted, I came in here with only 7 hearts. It's gonna take a while to actually refill the hearts, and unless you just die, which you'd start with all your health by default. Okay, this guy's just in the way. Damn it. I will take one feather, sure. All the glitchy stuff from the flippers. I tell you, the flippers. Is there any way to make them not do that glitchy stuff? I wonder. At least it's not as bad as the fire snakes. I mean, they're awesome sprites, but... Even in this ROM hack, I've had it crash once, and... Surprise, surprise, there was a fire snake when it did. I looked at them suspiciously when I was playing the crater, and if I ever see one again, then yeah, same thing. I don't know what it is with that fire snake that likes to crash the game. Wished I knew what it was. Oh, I got a cherry. Then again, it doesn't really matter. I need like 4 more. I don't even think I'll find 4 more in this level. Okay, we have to cross... Okay, we need to actually survive. Alright, let's cross the gap. Damn it. And we're back! There we go! Yeah, how much more level was there? After the point where I died? Because I ran out of health? Well, I actually decided to be more careful this time. That's why I have, like, a lot more health than the last run. Sure, I may not have any other... Okay, there's the ending. Okay, now this next level. Ominous Omen Trail. There's one part of the level in particular that I'm kind of worried about trying to pass. It involves tricky jumps. I'll tell you that. I need to be ready for some really tricky jumps. That's all I can say. Not all I can say, all I will say until I tell you what it is. And everything else, I really don't know what's going to be up ahead. Granted, I've seen a bit of this Omen Trail. I said only a bit. Oh my god. I'm just getting hit. Okay, there's the invisible block. There's another cherry. There's a slope. Are we almost there? That part that I want to see if I can actually do. Hey, jumped. Okay, now this we have to time perfectly. It's gonna be real fun. Invisible blocks everywhere! Oh boy! Yeah, I only figured out, like, somewhere during the Master Prison that wherever you see stray coins like that, there'll be invisible blocks. Kind of explains why I actually stumbled into quite a few of those. This part looks especially tricky! Try jumping on top of the switches after hitting them. It's best to try to go for it while the enemies are moving up. Hop on one to hit the switch with your head, then hop on the other to try and land on top of that switch. Rinse and repeat. Just in case you do it once, you gotta make sure you can do it more than once. Oh, so he wants me to do that multiple times in a row. I fucked up. Sure. Yeah, I have to somehow make it happen. These jumps are the devil incarnate. But I think the trick is to give yourself a lot of room, and then you need to give yourself more room. You need to give yourself, like, as much room as I'm giving myself. Like, look what I'm doing. I've been giving myself a lot of space. Like, almost as soon as these things start flying up, I jump on them. Wait, now, oh, okay. I need to jump on one to hit the switch, once to... Okay, now is this just jumping off of Koopa's hitting switches, or what? At least this is easier than what I was trying to do before. Yeah, that was pretty crazy. I have to do like 5 of those really tricky jumps in a row, like yeesh. But like once you know the technique, give yourself more space than you think you'll need, you'll pull it off because they will be moving up as you're jumping off them, so... Yeah, you have to consider the fact they're still going to be moving up as you're going to jump on them, both of them, so you can make it on top of the switch, and give yourself enough room to do that. Now it's just a matter of jumping off this bullet to reach that other piece of ground. Just need to time it right, though. There we go. Ominous Omen Trail. Another star. Let's go! This is the place. There's the final castle and where most of the endgame... The endgame, from what I hear, is even bigger than it was in the crater. And... The crater was pretty huge. Like, the whole Tower of Synth thing. This is gonna be bigger than the Tower of Synth. Hunter's Mountain, let's just go right for it. Let's just go straight into it. Not waste any Man, that thunder, though. Kinda distracting in a way, but... I guess it adds the nature of the level. Yeah, this is gonna be. This is probably gonna be absolutely crazy. Hey, was I supposed to hit that? Let's see. Oh boy. Ah, sheesh, I almost fell. I almost fell in the lava. Man, these are gonna be tricky to manage jumps. You gotta keep dodging little balls of fire. And I somehow screwed that up because my jump button didn't work. Let's try this again. Alright, there we go. Now we're gonna be seeing some new level. Or more new level, that is. Yeah, I definitely need to hit that switch to be able to advance. As you can just see right there. So, really, a lot of these disappearing on-off blocks are gonna... Well, actually, they're technically not on-off blocks, but a lot of these disappearing and reappearing blocks. And wait, do I have to somehow get up there? I think so. Let's hit that switch, because I'm sure it has something to do with what's gonna... Now I need to find the ground. Ah, never mind. Yeah, I probably did need that. Yeah. Oh boy, this thing again. Wonder how long this level is gonna be. Yikes, a lot of these Venus Fire Trap eye things, or whatever you call them in this game. So they probably have their own. Oh, now the hearts are white. Hey, the hearts changed color. One of these orbs that moves up. That pretty much follows me vertically, so I need to do something like that to pass under it, or over it, or whatever the best way to do it would be. Another orb. So it just moves back and forth between a wall horizontally, just on its own. I got a lot of stuff here, but 11 hearts is gonna make this pretty easy. Well, kind of easy. Because I have like 11 hearts, so I can take a lot of hits. Like, that is huge. Okay. Wait. What's going on here? I can't hit this block. It's the block that just doesn't want to be hit. I don't know. Okay, you can't go down there, but then again, I think you could just duck slide to go through there. Oh, crap. Really? Crap. I'm gonna have to wait here for these blocks to appear. Not even know where the other ones are gonna appear. Oh, that was close. Oh, and I died right near the ending. Sad face. Hazy Hazard Hall is gonna come next episode.